And the next speaker is a software architect and a software engineer. I know his work Titan because I caught him on a train heading to the mountains somewhere on Saturday, and he told me he'll have the slides by 10 today and that they were in at 9:38. So actually quite amazing. He will tell us about what he calls fast food software and what I would call personally do-it-yourself software. Please welcome Igor Savchuk.
Hello everyone, I'm Igor Savchuk, and as my previous speakers say, the application is the bus. So it's a lot of doing about the applications, about the creating applications, and I have done my research of a tool to creating the application. I will do it in my free time, so a lot of coding, a lot of creating, a lot of being on the computer. But what I can tell you, and you are a great audience, open-minded audience, that there will be a change in creating apps. We all know how it looks like, to create apps. We go to the software, we create tons of code. Yes, this does not look like how to create the apps. But we create tons of code, we create tons of tests, the developers sit and develop and test and catch bugs. So what happens in next few years? So we should forget about all the coding. We should forget about all this stuff, no matter. Of course, the programmers will still code, but ordinary people like you, not like me because I'm a programmer, will not code anymore. They will create like the bricks. So imagine the chaos of bricks, of Lego bricks. You have different colors, you have different shapes, and you start to building them, and you start to building a great structures. The great structures that can show your friends or can share with another. So this is hardware. Okay, but we talk about software. As Michał said, software we can share, software we can give away. So it all began with the Web 2.0 revolution, we could say. So we discovered that we are not only consumers of content, we can produce it. So a lot of technology came, so the ease of use, usability, new designs, new colors, schemes, and so on. But really, this is not a revolution. This is also still evolution of us creating and consuming the content. We, and I believe in it, in next few years, all we will consume, control, and produce content. Of course, there are a lot of people that claim they can only give you a opportunity to control content. But what I believe, anyone can create applications. It's like fast food. Of course, it's not quality software. It's not software which you sell or which you give to your best business clients. But it's easy to use, easy to produce, fast to deploy, and cheap to maintain. This software gives you ability to not only to share with your community, but also give you ability to express yourself. And imagine that you have some desires, and these desires are not met by programmers, are not met by big companies, but big factories. But you can build on your own, using the standard components, which are like Lego bricks. For example, the big data aggregators will allow you to build using the standard components. For example, you get the friends from Facebook, you get the prices from Amazon, and you start to build the application. So, still we have time. Okay, kittens, great. Let's get the example of application we want to build. For example, we love cats. Imagine that. And what we do, we go to the price checker list, get the plugin of the best prices of cat food, get the plugin of maps, for example, and put it together and build the application called Burek, Szarek, or something else that you can give to your friends and give and use, of course. And that's all. Thank you.